Let's take a look at how setTimeout might be implemented if it was written natively in JavaScript and we could go read the file somewhere. We'll pretend for a moment that it's defined in a file somewhere called timers.js. What would you expect to see appearing in this file? I mean, first of all, there'd be a function definition where setTimeout is a variable defined and made to point at some function. That function would of course take two arguments, your callback and the number of milliseconds to wait before calling that callback. What would happen in the body of the function? Well, first of all, of course, somehow the system delays execution of your callback by a number of milliseconds. Note that if you understand how JavaScript's concurrency model works, you know this couldn't actually be done in native JavaScript, but it's still a useful example to imagine. The next thing that setTimeout would have to do is refer to your function, and it would have to somehow invoke it. Here, we're finally able to ask ourselves the question, what values is setTimeout likely to pass along to your callback function? Since setTimeout has no way of knowing what values you wanted passed to your function, perhaps it would be forced to simply invoke it with no parameters at all. If that were the case, what would you expect to be shown in the last position of the log output?